What is up, Cardboard Nation? Oh, we missed you guys. It's been an hour without you. It's actually been 7 days without you, plus an hour. And what is that my eyes see? We have a fresh co-host tonight on the show.
I'm back.
That's right. I'm Ivan Lovgren at Watch the Breaks on Twitter. You're watching GoGTS Live, and joining us live on camera tonight, filling in for Rob Bertrand, is Therm Scissor Punch himself. No, that is James Gale, the asset, as you know him from behind the scenes, in front of the scenes. James, how are
I'm
you?
I'm doing
tonight?
Well, Ivan. Just to get it out of the way, Rob is having some technical difficulties. We've been working hard. He's been working hard behind the scenes. And
is
working hard right now. We might have box breaks tonight, but in the event that we don't, we have some backup giveaways to do. So if you're watching, don't tune out. We've got a lot of great content to show you tonight. Ivan's got some stuff to give away. Hot in the shop. Hobby happenings. Anything else?
Well, I'm holding up to the camera right now. The first of the giveaways, which is actually a 4-card lot of a few of the hits that I had from the 3 or 4 packs that I opened at the NFLPA Rookie Premiere. So that is Damon Webb. And then Saquon Barkley, both his base and his image variation, as well as a Ronnie Harrison number to 25. If that's not enough for you, though, we also have an on-card auto from Detroit Lions running back Kerryon Johnson. This is an on-card in-person auto that one lucky viewer will win. As well as, I don't know which of these is bigger, so I'm just going to show them both at the same time. A Josh Allen insert with an on-card in-person auto, and then a Saquon Barkley-Mike Gesicki dual on-card auto insert. So we know that Barkley is hot. Gesicki is with the Dolphins, and he was also at the event. And then Josh Allen, the number one pick for the Buffalo Bills. So we're at least going to have that to give away. There is a chance, though. We've got some time to get the technical difficulties worked out, and we might have a couple of high-end box breaks.
That's right.
So that would be very exciting. But in the meantime, we've got even more stuff, great content, the box breaks, lots of video content and segments tonight. Including an exclusive interview with professional wrestler Velvet Sky and a cardboard career retrospective from Russ Cohen at Sportsology, our good friend of the show. So that's something to look forward to, as well as you're actually going to finally get, we talked last week about the rookie premiere. James, we have how many videos detailing and showing what actually happened
there? We have three videos. Since I got back to the house on Thursday, I've been uploading video to the computer, offlining it, editing it, making sure everything's good. We have an interview with Tracy Hackler from Thursday's event at GTS Customer Appreciation Day. That's where the event we covered on last week's show. Mm-hmm. We have a
one-on-one with Tracy himself.
And what's a one-on-one with Tracy? All Tracy. In that video. The video after that is going to be a recap of GTS Customer Appreciation Day. So that'll have interviews with GTS customers, a few behind-the-scenes looks.
Such as Irving Manera, perhaps, who just joined us in
Irving
chat,
Manera,
who is the host of Mustache Mondays.
He is in the video, I can confirm.
Hey! So Irving, don't go anywhere.
He was in the background and also, on one of those shots. I had to cut around it because he was being silly in the background. But
Irving? No, never.
So we have that video, GTS customers. You kind of see what it was like at GTS Customer Appreciation Day. And then our final video is one I was able to get done today, and that is you and I went out to Cal State Lutheran University up in Thousand Oaks, California, right by the Ronald Reagan Library.
Presidential
That's
Library.
That's right. We didn't go there. We went to Cal State Lutheran. And we saw the players on the field doing their rookie photo shoot. They were signing autographs. Fanatics was there doing things. People were doing interviews. So a lot of action from Saturday. I cut it together into a fun little video. There's some fun surprises in there. So stay tuned for that.
Awesome. And then, of course, we'll have Hot in the Shop as well as a preview of next week's episode. And before anything else, we have a GoGTS Live question of the week. It's on our Twitter, so make sure that you go to Twitter. Wherever you're watching right now, go to twitter.com/GoGTSLive and vote in our GoGTS Live Q of the Week poll.
And you know what, Ivan? Also, it is pinned because yes. There is no Periscope feed. So it is...
Oh, there's no Periscope feed tonight?
Well, we're going to do a little behind-the-scenes talk right now, but it's not there. Oh, okay, but the okay. Q of the Week,
we might get
Q of the Week poll is up. We have 94 votes.
Okay, well, the Q of the Week, it goes a different direction. I'm going to give you two guesses what my answer is to this. What is the bigger story in sports entertainment news this week? Is it A, the WWE SmackDown deal with Fox, B, the UFC deal with ESPN, or C, don't care? And if you've been following me on Twitter, you know that I
don't care. But when I wrote the tweet,
James is responsible for the tweets. I'm responsible for the show notes. Rob's rolling over in his grave because he does the show notes. You guys get my opinion with these things. You can't cut it out of the show. You got to deal with it.
Yeah.
And mine is C, don't care. Come on. I know it's a little throw out to Velvet Sky, who I saw a lot of you were excited about in the chat rooms. But for me, the bigger sports story this week is NBA playoffs. NHL playoffs,
that's not news,
baseball,
though.
May baseball. All of those are bigger stories in sports entertainment to me. Even the Solo movie, which I'm not even excited for. I think that's bigger news than who signs what deal. You know, and I guess it's good that WWE has moved from USA to what was it,
Fox.
TNT or something? Fox. Well, but before that,
I was on UPN when I was a kid. I don't remember where it was. UPN was considered a major network, right?
Not a network.
Yeah, it was.
So the networks have always been CBS, ABC, NBC, and then Fox. Those four.
But there's more than. But I mean,
those are
WGN was
the other
network.
Ones.
A network. Right.
No, it was the Superstation. So it was a station, but it was a superstation because it was sent out so far. It was considered a superstation. The networks have always been those
but
four.
UPN was carried on many local stations.
Yeah.
So that's what we got as a kid. That's
a
where SmackDown was.
It was a channel.
It's going to Fox. That's pretty big, I guess. I as somebody who doesn't follow wrestling, but like it's Fox is a major network, and that's like that's a pretty big get for them, I would think. They're going all in on TV. Yeah. Tim Allen.
Well, James, do you have the Twitter up? Are you able to tell us what it is that the vote is at?
Yeah,
right now,
sure. I'm going to bring it up right now. ESPN getting UFC is pretty big too. Although, isn't it on one of the Fox Sports networks?
It was.
But ESPN.
So
I'm
guessing that now
they
it's
need to ESPN. ESPN needs to pivot. And
we
so,
actually just got an update, and I appreciate this. Bad Wolf Cards on Facebook. I have just a little bit of bandwidth to pay attention to comments. So UPN had a limited broadcast time. So whatever channel that was, UPN would only broadcast their content from 4 p.m. to 9 p.m. or something like that. And then if you tuned in at like 10 a.m., it technically wasn't UPN. It was like
local people running Honeymooners reruns.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yep.
So we have 94 votes in the poll. 30% went to WWE going to SmackDown going to Fox. 21%. UFC deal with ESPN, and then 49%, almost 50% didn't really resonate with them, which that was also my vote. I don't follow each sport, but that was an option, and so that's what people picked. So yeah.
All right. Well, it's wonderful that I know if Rob were here, he would have some good insight on that because I know that he follows both. But we got to talk about it. We got to have some fun, share our opinions. Yeah. That said, are we ready to jump in? Okay. Well, we're gonna turn it over to the experts. Here's going to be a look at Tracy Hackler filling us in on not only the NFLPA Rookie Premiere, but also what Panini has in store between now and the start of football season. So, here's what's hot in Tracy Hackler's world.
Tracy, we're here at the NFLPA Rookie Premiere. This year there were six rookies on stage with you. What did you think about this year's group and what really struck you?
The group as a whole was phenomenal. Maybe our best yet, not just in terms of the caliber of the player, they're all first round picks with some Heisman Trophy winners in there, number one overall, number two overall, number three overall, number five overall. Their closeness was obvious from the very beginning. Usually when we do this event with you guys, there's a little cooling warm-up period where you gotta kind of draw information out. They were on it from the very beginning. So I think their sense of humor was awesome and obvious. It's clear to me that they've bonded throughout this whole combine, NFL draft, and now the NFL process. So that was fun. And just the amount of laughter that I heard was so cool, not just from the players themselves, but from the people watching and listening. When that happens and the room's kind of uproarious and laughter, that's a good thing.
Now tell us again, we got to see a lot of stuff. There's so much social media now that we really saw what happened at the Rookie Premiere Customer Appreciation Day. What else goes on around this crazy event? How many days, what other things do you get to do behind the scenes that we don't see?
Yeah, so things kick off in earnest Wednesday night when the first players arrive, and they'll come downstairs into our room and they'll start signing. And from Wednesday through Saturday night, there's not a more important, bigger scale event for us anytime on the calendar. It's our most important football event of the year, arguably our most important event of the year, because we acquire so much content, autographs, memorabilia, photography, video, social media content, that will drive our products not only for the rest of 2018, but well into the future. So a lot of autograph signing, a lot of memorabilia acquisition, and then that's the business side of it, but we also use this time to enrich or further enhance our relationships with these players that we're going to be working with for years to come.
What's an upcoming Panini football product that you are most excited for?
I'm going to give you a couple that I've seen come to fruition today and yesterday a little bit. It's Luminance Football. It was a brand new product on the calendar, didn't really know what to expect. But after seeing the early returns of the on-card autographs, it looks phenomenal. It's a darker looking design aesthetic, but college imagery on it. But man, to see some of these darker cards signed with like light blue paint pen or ink, and the autographs pop. And so we're really excited about that. When Luminance Football, look for it. And then another brand new product, Elements Football. When you hear metal base cards, it's a little, some people love it, some people are a little sketchy on it. I saw the Elements base cards being signed here today, and those look great too, with the blue, the gold, the silver. It's just something different. There's a certain heft to the cards that really stands out, but to see the blue ink shining off the metal, strong look, and so I think Elements is another one that I'm looking forward to.
Tell me something, you know, we do know collectors love this, they complain about this. What are the improvements in your existing brands that Panini's really focused on this year from the collector feedback?
I mean, I think more on card. We've heard that for years and years and years, and although I don't think we'll ever be able to go 100% on card in every product, we do strive to increase the amount of on card autographs in our products. You saw that with an early product in Contenders Draft Picks Football, a lot of guys that we sat with at the Combine, which is something we didn't do 3 or 4 years ago, but we're taking those strides to acquire more on card, and so you'll see that continue through the rest of the season. Another thing too is just working with players on the quality of their signatures and not giving us give up signatures. Some guys, that's how they sign, that's their autograph, and we can't control that, but when guys are taking the time, and more it seems every year the classes are learning that their signature is an extension of their brand and of their, it's a way for them to market themselves. And I think they do take pride in that. And I think you'll see that throughout this rookie class as well. The NFLPA Rookie Premiere is probably my favorite event that we do every year. But this day of the Rookie Premiere, when we get to work with GTS and our partners at the NFLPA to kind of show these players in a new light, take the helmet off, have fun with them, it really engenders goodwill for the people who are going to buy their rookie cards, and it really helps us enrich our relationships with them and with GTS, and we're thrilled to be able to do that.
Well, that was fun. That was Tracy Hackler from Panini America talking about the NFLPA Rookie Premiere. Now, James, I conducted the interview, so I know what Tracy had to say. Let me ask you, though, what are your thoughts outside of the event? Because we enjoyed that and we've got more content from it. What are your thoughts about what Tracy had to say about the improvements that Panini is striving to make and sort of their lineup before before the football season begins?
I mean, it's smart. They want to get more on-card content earlier. And I'm going to tease another interview from an upcoming video, but somebody mentions the on-card autographs that are already in contenders' draft picks, which they in the past was probably 100% stickers, 95% stickers. And so now that they're trying to cut those numbers down, and it's, I mean, there's a lot of moving parts, and it's a hard process. And they're putting in the work. So I think it's positive. You and I both saw players signing like crazy on Saturday. I didn't see any stickers being signed on Saturday either. It was all cards and sketch cards too. Or they're not sketch cards, but player sketch cards. You know what I'm saying? They were working on those.
Yeah, there's a lot of cool things. I did see stickers being signed.
You did? Okay. So
full disclosure. Yeah.
I didn't.
But again, there's such a strong effort to get on card. And that's actually another, we do have to thank Panini for giving us access. This is Panini's time with the players.
Yep.
And they're taking some of that time to let us do that customer appreciation day. So that's very cool of them to share that with us and with the customers.
It's a busy weekend. I mean, just thinking, Tracy's probably going a mile a minute everywhere working 18-hour days all weekend. So it's a big process for them. It isn't all like shaking hands and being fun with players, and you know.
Oh, there's a reason I interview him on Thursday.
Right?
I waited till Saturday. As great as he is.
But he did tease Elements Football, which is a new product this year. Either I did the solicitation or Rob and I did it together. But it's the metal cards. It's kind of based off the periodic table. Mm-hmm. For some reason, I've always thought the idea of the periodic table of elements was, it's a good design. It's good graphic design, right?
It's good graphic design, but where were you going with that? What do you think about the periodic table of elements?
It's good graphic design. It looks neat when it's published, even, you know, all the elements. Okay. And so that's what this set is kind of based on that with. And the metal cards. But one of the preview images is Stefon Diggs making the Minneapolis Miracle catch. And as a Viking fan who has a video of Paul Allen making the call that I watch regularly, I will own that card. Excellent. So, yeah.
Well,
that should be a fun set.
Yeah. And that made up to you as a Vikings fan for there being no Vikings at the rookie premiere. Which is part of why you were so good at doing your job, I guess.
Yeah,
you
know, no, I didn't care.
Like I was.
None of my players were there, so I didn't care.
Awesome. Well, Joe, are we ready?
So, it's time for a little segment we like to call Hobby Happenings. And I'll be doing Rob's part this week.
Right, the pressure
but
is on.
But I can't look at the camera. I got to look over at my notes here. So.
Okay.
It's one of the most iconic images in the hobby. Ken Griffey Jr.'s The Kid, sporting his signature smile on his 1989 Upper Deck rookie card. But did you know that the image isn't the original photograph? The actual photograph pictured here on the left is Polaroid from when the 1987 first overall draft pick played with the San Bernardino Spirits. See, Ivan, back when guys like Joe and I were listening to cassette tapes and dropping off film to be developed at a photo mat and turned into prints, all things I definitely did, there was this thing called a Polaroid, which was a self-developing, self-printing camera that made a slight return in the late 90s, early aughts. Anyway,
you may be surprised to know that I have one myself, James.
Oh, I bet you do. Anyway, the story of how Griffey came to be the number one card in Upper Deck's inaugural set is a classic and well-known tale best told by the man responsible for its fate. But to give those new to the hobby a crash course in the card's history real quick, Tom Guideman, co-owner of Sage Trading Cards, was Upper Deck's first employee and was tasked with putting the 1989 Upper Deck Baseball Checklist together. Known locally as the Baseball Prospect Whiz, Guidman would go from high school, excuse me, and rookie card stockbroker to a card shop and card company executive in little over a year and a half. When asked about the gamble of putting Griffey at number one, he simply said that Griffey had bigger upside than the other contender, Greg Jeffries, and set out to convince his boss, hobby veteran Jay McCracken. As they say, the rest is history. So why are we talking about this? Well,
that's a great question.
The Polaroid, originally owned by Tom Guidman, sold this week through Memory Lane for nearly $14,000. The only other owner of the card was the consigner, who just happened to be the aforementioned Jay McCracken. And just how did they get that Mariners logo on Griffey's hat a full year before Photoshop even came to market? A color-correcting machine well used in 1980s printing called the Skytex. And, you know, Cytex? Cytex. On to you, bud.
All right. Well, we like to give you a challenge to start off with, and you handled it with aplomb. In other hobby news, one of the hobby's true white whales sold this past week at Heritage Auctions. Despite playing a full quarter century in a major league uniform, Eddie Collins remains an enormously challenging hurdle for collectors of Hall of Fame single-signed baseballs. It's a bit of a mystery, actually, that so few could exist. Heritage's comprehensive auction results database indicates only 3 sales by any major house in the past 20 years. Any major house. Which explains this late 1930s official American League ball signed by the legendary pitcher selling for over $55,000. Also in upcoming auction news, one of the featured items in Leland's Invitational Auction is this lot of over 70,000 1971 Topps baseball cards from what is being called the Hoarder Collection. And you may recall from a feature we did last year that this set includes a notoriously condition-sensitive set, and this find includes many potentially high-grade examples. So look for those to hit the PSA registry after this auction.
Well, Ivan, for anyone who has ever collected an autograph, the just-released book entitled Waiting for a Sign is a must-read. Author Kevin Keating has spent a lifetime collecting autographs of some of the biggest names in baseball. A native from Chicago, he spent much of his youth acquiring thousands of signatures from major leaguers, visiting the Windy City to play against his hometown Cubs or White Sox. He rooted for them both, I think. By the time he graduated from high school, he had amassed more than 10,000 autographs. One of Keating's favorite locations to acquire signatures was the entrance to the Executive Hotel, now the Wyndham Grand Chicago Riverfront, which has probably seen a decent remodeling. Where the visiting team stayed. He also wrote to retired players through the mail, always enclosing a self-addressed stamped envelope. Smart. Waiting for a Sign chronicles Keating's personal journey through the decades of encounters and correspondence with some of the sport's most important and colorful personalities. In the 348-page book, Volume 1 and 2, with more than 100 illustrations, Keating describes many memorable meetings and some near misses with such Major League Baseball legends as Ted Williams, Joe DiMaggio, Hank Aaron, Rod Carew, Stan Musial, wow, Mickey Mantle, and Roger Maris.
Oh my goodness.
And he recounts how he befriended many of the game's greats, including Hall of Fame members Yogi Berra, Whitey Ford, and Johnny Meze, to name a few.
Collectors know, as much as we like the new wax, it's not all about the new wax here at GoGTS Live. In fact, you may have noticed unopened boxes of 1979-80 Opeachy hockey don't come to market very often. Those that still have the rudimentary but familiar piece of the company's signature tape over the front lid are virtually non-existent at this point in time. You knew there was a butt coming, didn't you?
Mm.
That's right, just like the first time you got dumped. Collectors who've been searching for the whitest of vintage hockey wax white whales can finally stop looking. There's one in Heritage Auction's upcoming summer catalog auction with a pre-sale estimate of $60,000 or more. Heritage officials believe it's the only 7980 OPC hockey box ever to come to auction that still has the original tape on the front. The Canadian issues of the era were bigger than their Topps counterparts, and the 7980 issue contains 48 packs of 14 cards, making it likely there's at least one or two high-grade Wayne Gretzky rookie cards inside. The box has been authenticated by Steve Hart of Baseball Card Exchange. And thank you, Sports Collectors Daily, for breaking that story.
Back in the day, sports cards, especially baseball cards, were everywhere, including the backs of post cereal boxes. And I am old enough to remember that. Maybe not these ticker tape machines that Rob was talking about. But this summer, that thrill returns, but it won't be baseball cards. To capitalize on the hype of the 2018 World Cup, collectors can find Topps MLS soccer cards on the backs of select Post cereal products. Post is the official cereal of the U.S.-based Pro Soccer League, and the card promotion is a part of a summer-long series of other family-oriented promotions the company has planned.
Oh, hey, here's something you don't see every week. A hobby-related story about Shohei Ohtani. Two, in fact. So, after upping his offer for the as-of-yet unfound 2018 Bowman Superfractor Auto, Tom Fish of Blowout Cards added two additional offers to the list. Anyone pulling additional Kanji autographs or red refractor autographs numbered to 5 can sell them directly to the online retail giant for $25,000 a pop. When you consider eBay and PayPal fees and the risk involved, I'd say that's a pretty good offer versus what they've sold for on eBay. And yesterday, Upper Deck announced that autographs of the Japanese sensation will be randomly inserted into several autograph sets of the always popular Goodwin Champions. In addition to the Goodwin Champions autographs of Shohei Ohtani, collectors attending this year's National Sports Collectors Convention in Cleveland, the first week of August, will have the opportunity to pull a limited number of Ohtani autographs as part of the company's annual Prominent Cuts promotional pack redemption program. Sign me up.
Kanji? Another week, another find. Well, not really a find per se. This person knew he was blessed with a mother that didn't throw out his collection of late 40s and 50s early baseball cards, but suffice it to say, a new hoard of high-grade vintage cards is coming to market this summer. After reading about last month's sale of the $2.88 million 1952 Topps Mickey Mantle card, the consignor contacted Heritage with details about his childhood collection. In all, the collection included more than 3,000 cards, including more than 100 higher grade, 1952 Topps high numbers, including 4 Jackie Robinsons and 5 Mickey Mantles. Other cards in this amazing collection include a Mantle rookie and 3 Willie Mays rookies from the 1951 Bowman set, 2 1948-49 Leaf Robinson rookies, and hundreds of other cards, all dating from the early days of post-war bubblegum sets. Wow. Just sitting around. The collection's current market value, suffice it to say the retired gentleman who owns these cars is excited beyond belief, and the thought of a 7-figure payday when bidding begins in late June. For more details about this collection, be sure to read Rich Miller's article on Sports Collectors Daily. Wow.
Also, PSA has finished grading the 5 Mantles, and you can see the grades that they got from 8.5 down to 5, 5 being the worst. Incredible.
Yeah.
Finally, in crime news, you may remember a story we brought you last year involving a theft ring in Minnesota targeting sports memorabilia businesses. The FBI is now handling the investigation and has a suspect. ABC5 News in Minneapolis has more on this developing story.
And that's a look at this week's Hobby Happenings. Oh, I'm hearing did I miss a story?
Embrace your own renaissance in Italy with Globus Journeys. Stand inside the storied walls of the Colosseum or...
The FBI is now leading the investigation into a major theft ring targeting family-owned businesses. Thieves hit 5 sports memorabilia stores in these 4 cities across the metro. In all, about $250,000 in merchandise has been taken. Jay Coles has been tracking this case for more than a year now, and Jay's live in Roseville with these new developments. Jay?
Leah, right behind me here, Three Stars Sports Cards is one of those businesses in Roseville that was hit by the theft ring in 2017. Now, this new Anoka County search warrant indicates there is at least one suspect that's been identified and multiple houses that are now being searched looking for evidence.
Wonderful. Let me also, did I give you a card?
Over $100,000 in high-end sports memorabilia gone, and things are not the same at Twin City Sports Cards as a result.
I no longer keep the good stuff here.
Right.
I mean, the really expensive stuff you've got to ask for. It's in the deposit box, and that's when it comes out.
Two of Rob Henning's Golden Valley stores were hit by thieves last year, and he says he easily lost over $100,000 in merchandise.
They smash and grab, and it takes 5 minutes. They're in and out.
Investigators say this spot, Ultimate Collectibles in Hopkins, was hit, Three Stars in Roseville, and Ninth Inning Sports, which operates out of this St. Paul building, were all burglarized too, with more than $250,000 in sports memorabilia taken from all of them combined. Henning's was one of the hardest hit.
Between the two stores, well over 100. Absolutely.
This search warrant says the St. Paul Sports Memorabilia Store was hit for over $100,000 as well. And the warrant indicates this Stillwater home was searched just last week. And another warrant is now being executed at a home in Blaine. No one was home at either place when we showed up. The Anoka County search warrant says one suspect has been tracked selling some of the stolen goods on eBay. But so far, no arrests. And Rob Henning says investigators tell him they also have a DNA sample with a match and a name.
They're looking for him also, so there's obviously more than one.
Now, the Hennepin County Sheriff's Office says the FBI is the lead agency in this investigation. I did reach out to the FBI for comment, but I have not yet heard back from them. Reporting live in Roseville, Jay Coles, 5 Eyewitness News.
Well, it's great to see that they are doing something about that, because nothing worse than seeing such a hit to hobby shops. And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings.
You got it. I didn't. I messed up. But we'll edit it out, and the video clips people
okay.
watch, they won't even know I messed
that's
it
okay.
up.
No, no. You got to leave it. You got to leave it fresh. You got to own that, which is fine.
I could.
You did. You did.
Sure.
You was so now you understand why I have 4 beverages around me at all times during this show.
Oh, yeah.
It's arduous, doesn't it?
Good news, though. Good hobby happenings.
Yeah, especially three-star sports cards specifically. I actually know the guys that run the shop, and they were at the National last
GTS
year.
GTS customer.
And...
Right?
Oh, they are.
I think
oh,
so. That, I think they participated in National Hobby Shop Day. But okay. And they are. Yep, we're getting confirmation. But yeah, no, that's
really,
my
I mean,
neck of the woods.
All 4 of the shops.
We used to go to a store in the Twin Cities called Schinder's, which was a chain. They at least knew of 3 locations, but they're not there anymore, I don't think. Mm-hmm. Maybe there's 1 left, but it's tough to hear that happened in the Twin Cities, but hopefully they'll get their guy. Good investigative journalism,
yeah.
Knocking on doors, putting
yep.
pressure on them, so yeah. And then of course those mantles, right?
It is good to see the authorities, you know, the FBI, in fact, doing something about it, because sadly we've all, well, maybe we haven't, hopefully we haven't all, but, you know, I've at least heard reports of people where you get robbed and they show up and all they say is, well,
file a report.
Can't really do much, but, you know, they're,
yep.
they're following
tough.
Up on that. So we were excited to share that with you. And yeah, lots of other great hobby news. Otani, some other stuff.
Kanji.
Otani. Yep. Kanji.
So only 1 Kanji autograph has been found so far?
Only 1. And it was the same number as the one that Topps
teased. Is that the only one? Have they confirmed that there are more?
There, not that I know of, has there been word. Now, I don't always get all the words,
yeah,
so please
right.
pass along word if you have it. But I do know, I believe it was card 27. Don't quote me on that. It's in the 20s. And I know of a breaker who pulled number 30, and it was not Kanji, because it was the 150 blue
okay.
variant. And I've heard a report of someone pulling the 10, and it was not Kanji. So if they're fed to him in order, that tells you something.
Yeah,
I'll let you interpret when it tells you. But it tells you something.
I'm curious to see if there are actually any more. Or if that's the one.
It'll be interesting. Yeah. That's why it's commanding as much as a number to five right now. Hey, real quick, in my ear, are we having any chance of box breaks? Or should we run into the next segment?
So, yeah, okay. I apologize because I wrote all the tweets today promoting these box breaks, and they're really good. Majestic, $300 a box.
There's still time. I'm not giving
Dominion,
up hope. I know that Rob's
$280
working hard
a box, Classics, which looks really slick.
I'm not giving up hope because we got a lot
of
content to get
and
through.
And you know what? If we don't open them this week, we're going to open them next week. It's not like they go away and disappear. Yeah. Rob has them in hand.
Yeah.
So, yes. We have two more videos that I put together this week from all the footage we got from the NFLPA Rookie Premiere. The first video is covering GTS Customer Appreciation Day. So that's you're going to see a Q&A with first rounders only. Only first rounders were let into this Q&A. And some great insight from GTS customers who were able to attend the event. Video that runs after that is going to be from when Ivan and I were on the field at Cal State Lutheran University in Thousand Oaks, California for Panini. Panini ran that event, right? It was them and the NFL.
Panini. I'm not 100% certain because there was also groups like Fanatics, EA Sports, lots of different companies.
It was a busy day. We were there. We were there courtesy of Panini. Thanks again to Tracy Hackler, Scotty Prusha, others. Who made it happen. And so there's a lot more.
Lucy on the field who let us on.
Yep, that's right, Lucy. She was just a deer to let us on. So D-E-A-R, not D-E-E-R. There's a lot more action in that video. It's light on the interviews, but there's some good.
I'm glad you clarified, James, because I thought we were going back to calling women dogs.
Yeah, right. Oh, boy, that'd be troubling.
From those days when you were popping cassette tapes.
Looking at the ticker tape. Yep.
So. Well, without further ado, let's just jump in, and here's back-to-back videos on the GTS Customer Appreciation Day and the NFLPA Rookie Photo Shoot.
Check it out.
Here at the NFL Rookie Photo Shoot, definitely an honor being here and Panini giving us the invite and that kind of stuff, so it's great. Getting a chance to hang out with all these rookies each and every year is pretty special, hanging out with some of the biggest football stars, before they get their career starts, great.
And who from the lineup today are you most excited to see?
Probably Saquon. I'm ready to see Saquon. He wasn't at the Dallas, the pre-draft event down in Dallas, so I'm excited to see Saquon here.
It's just cool to see the players interact with each other. All the joking that they go, especially players who went to school together.
Yeah.
And now they're in the NFL together, maybe on separate teams. That's kind of cool to see them interact together. We get a lot of people talking about Bradley Chubb. Obviously, the quarterbacks that were drafted, Rosen, Darnold, Allen, Mayfield, all those guys. Everybody, it seems like when it comes to investments, when it comes to sports cards, especially football, quarterbacks are the way to go. Everybody wants to collect quarterbacks. As far as products that have come out in 2018, Contenders Draft Picks has been a really, really good one. Some on-card autos, which you don't usually see this early in releases. I think Mayfield's on-card. I think Nick Chubb is on-card. There's a handful of guys who are on-card, which is good to see. Usually, there's a lot of sticker autos in those early releases.
The
one-on-one interaction, you know, kind of seeing the personal side to players that to a lot of people are kind of bigger than life, and just kind of seeing them in their element. Yeah, just getting a different angle, you know, of the players.
From today's lineup of guys for the one-on-one, who are you most excited to see? And why?
You know, I mean, I think everyone is excited to see Baker just because, I mean, he's Baker and that personality. But Barkley, I really want to see. I get this vibe from him that he's just like a really grounded, down-to-earth dude. And I don't know, I just like to see that side of him. So, let's see.
Of the players that are here today, which one are you most excited to see?
Baker Mayfield.
And why is that?
Well, I'm a Cleveland Browns fan, so, and hopefully we can turn around our franchise. We've had a long, dry spell of quarterbacks. So.
And have you broken any products that have NFL rookies in them so far this year?
Yes. Yeah, Contenders Draft, Elite Draft, Score, Majestic.
And then since you guys have the break rooms, in the break rooms and in the chats, which players have guys been most excited for from this draft class so far in this race?
I mean, everyone's looking for Saquon, I think, probably. Baker Mayfield. Any of the quarterbacks, Allen, Rosen, Darnold. Contenders is definitely the big pull right now, the big money ones. I mean, some of the Majestic patch autos of some of the big names are selling well.
I like how they were all clowning each other. They were very relaxed today. Last time it seemed like some of them get a little uptight. Today they were all having a lot of fun with each other.
Now you're a brick and mortar shops, right?
Two of them are, yes.
Okay. What have you seen that's been really popular with collectors walking into the shops from the 2018 football season?
Oh my God, Contenders Draft football is amazing. Pretty much is the only one really out other than Score, which is it's really not a base product anymore. It's a $100 box, but for quality, the Contenders Draft.
This is my first year here, so it was very, very, very exciting. It was very nice to see all the players up front. Big shout out to GTS Distribution for inviting us. Very, very lucky to be here, and I really hope that in the future I get invited as well.
Awesome. Now, I imagine, have you ever been this close to players before?
Never been this close.
Okay. So what was something really fun that happened today that you enjoyed?
I love how the guys kind of interact with each other and have fun with them. They're very competitive, but in a very friendly way. A lot of those guys actually play against each other. It's very entertaining to watch them kind of attack smack a little against each other.
I think Chubbs is here, Chubb from the Broncos. So I'm a Bronco fan, so I got to meet him.
Awesome. Now, have you been breaking a lot of 2018 football so far?
Contenders draft picks. We did elites. No Majestic, but Contenders draft picks was on fire.
Awesome. And then in your chat rooms, who are you seeing guys chatter the most about? Who's hottest?
You've got Mayfield, Barkley, who's the kid? Michael from the Patriots, and Ridley from the Falcons. So they're getting a lot of buzz.
Great. And which products throughout the year are you most excited about?
Honestly, I'm looking forward to Elite. Elite football is it's a fun product. It's a long rip, but it's a fun product. Die cuts, you get the reverse jersey numbers, you get the golds, the greens, the one-on-ones. Just the answers itself is fun. Aside from that, I mean, anti-football always.
Just the contact we have with the guys, you know, seeing the new draft class up close, getting asked them questions, getting to take pictures, getting real personal with them. A couple years ago, we got to take pictures, you know, personal pictures with Joey Bosa, and get, you know, up close instant access to these guys. We've been doing a lot of Score football. That just came out. It's a lot of low-numbered autos that guys are chasing. We've hit a couple really, really nice Saquon Barkley's. We have a lot of Giants fans. So, you know, Giants are first team gone in every break. Guys are hunting all the Saquons they can get. We have a lot of Arizona Cardinals fans, so they're really geeked on Josh Rosen. And, you know, everyone's just chasing quarterbacks right now and their team. So, Broncos with Chubb, and, you know, I'm a Charger fan, so I'm buying Chargers and getting, you know, all their first round guys. So, everyone's real excited for this year. I think it's going to be a real lot of talent.
This was my first year, and the funnest part was getting to sit down close with them and get to ask them questions and get to hear about a little about their personal life. It was fun. I think that Lamar Jackson's joking around was pretty funny, and like when he said he was going to be a comedian, he was a funny guy.
Awesome.
Now, with your breaks, your online breaks, what have your people, your chatters in your chat rooms been saying as you've been doing football? Who are their rookies that they're all chasing?
Today there was a lot of people watching, and Saquon Barkley seemed to be the guy. A lot of people were like, I want Saquon Barkley, I want his autograph. He was the favorite, I think.
I think it's the premier event in the industry because you get to see top caliber athletes at a time where they're just coming out of college and are not necessarily NFL professionals yet. So it's a great time to see their true personalities and gives you an opportunity to root for the guys that you wouldn't expect to normally.
So what did you think about this year's group of athletes at the GTS Customer Appreciation?
Yeah, that it was fantastic. I mean, these guys obviously represent their class really well, or represent the NFLPA tremendously. They all have great character. And the thing that most impressed me probably was the camaraderie and the respect for them as competitors. Just going back and forth with, you know, Barkley and the comedic responses. And, you know, the guys just did a fantastic job altogether. Everybody that attended, I mean, all the people that I got a chance to talk to, were thrilled, you know, to get access like that to the top athletes in a great draft class like this. It surprised people. Flew from all over the country, and some of them flew in this morning and are flying out on a red eye tonight just for the opportunity to get that kind of access. And they're taking time away from their business and time away from their families to do that. But they all had a wonderful time. Nobody that I know left disappointed, and we're very grateful for Panini and the NFL for the opportunity.
Calvin, Ronald,
Juju,
alright, let's see that,
there you go,
that's what I got it.
Oh, you got it?
What does it say about you on that?
It says, my school, it says that Indiana was in trouble from the beginning, from the first whistle.
Oh, that's cool, you got yourself.
Kick return, 98 yards for the first kick return career.
My first year actually coming to this. We've had tickets in the past, but I've always given them to customers, and I kind of self-indulged this year and thought I'd come and bring employees of mine, and this is Aaron, this is Ben, backbone of my store, and I thought we'd take it in this year and enjoy it, and really, it's incredible. Seeing these guys in real life is unbelievable. It's amazing because once you meet them, all of a sudden you feel you know them. And now I'm going to watch a Bronco game, and I'm going to watch Chubb and go, hey, that's my favorite guy, and I know him.
So what's the coolest part about the event for you so far?
Just talking to the guys, saying hi, sharing names, taking a picture. Really, it's awesome. It's little things like that. And you don't realize how cool they are until you actually do it. And at the Thursday event, I got to talk to I made Baker Mayfield laugh. I did something to make him laugh, and it made my entire week.
It's not simple. Like, right. There's complexity to it.
Right, yeah.
Are you able to break it down for me just a little bit? Like,
just a K and a period for my first name, and then just a C-O-U-T, and then just a line through. It's like a continuation of the E-E. So something real just kind of short.
That's awesome. And how many autographs do you think you signed this week?
Do you want to know
the actual number?
4,500.
Yeah, I was 45. Yeah, that's probably
4,500. All right.
4,500. It's a lot of autographs.
How much fun was that? I actually had so much fun that it was fun to watch the video of it after the fact and see some of the shots that you got, James, and be reminded of some of the good times that I had there.
It was great. We had a great time. Action-packed. Yeah. There was something always happening. It's not like, I have a lot of footage of players sitting around kind of waiting to do something, but like they all had their own responsibilities, and you know, somewhere they had a that VIP area where people got their photos taken. There's photos of you with Josh Rosen out there on social media, right?
Yeah, well, and even in the at the very beginning, the Saquon Barkley clip, I was standing next. I was the one that encouraged him to open a pack to try and chase himself, and then he hit himself in that pack.
Very cool.
Because he was just hanging out. There was 12 people in the tent, and people in general are very respectful of the athletes as well, which I think they appreciate, which makes them happy to sign those autos for the select fans.
Yeah, it was really casual. These are first rounders, like big guys, like Saquon Barkley is getting like Adrian Peterson levels of hype, and if he even delivers half of that, like, well, three quarters of that is rookie season, like he's gonna be a star. And he was super down to earth and cool. Same with all the quarterbacks.
Oh,
yeah,
absolutely. Absolutely fantastic. So, and just a reminder, if you want a chance to win the autographs that I got, just a few, tried not to harass the players too much, but just a few for you guys, to thank you for watching the show. Josh Allen, Saquon Barkley, Kerryon Johnson, Mike Gesicki, as well as a little bonus pack. The tweet is live on Twitter to retweet and share. Get a couple of friends watching the show. And the more people watch, the more we get invited to things like this, the more that content is encouraged by companies like Panini and Upper Deck and Tops at all their events.
And you know what, Ivan?
Do that, and
there's another tweet out there featuring some of the photographs, the oversized cards, although I believe they're on a photograph stock, that were given away.
Are you talking about the 8x10s?
8x10s.
Of the classics, the reprints.
Yes.
The blow-ups.
Mm-hmm.
We have some of those?
We got two of them.
I don't have
any. And they are top five picks. We have number one overall pick, Baker Mayfield, and Sam Darnold. Rob has them. They will ship out with the, you know, it's all on Rob's schedule, but soon. You know, Monday at the latest.
But so we're giving those away.
We're giving
right
them
now
away.
On Twitter.
Yep.
Okay.
So there is
great
a tweet.
So make sure
for
you
those.
Go to.
And there's already 56 retweets.
Oh, I just found it, and I've got 68 online.
You see, oh gosh.
So it's climbing. Yeah. So you guys know where to find the giveaways. Twitter.com/GoGTSLive. Whatever channel you're watching on, YouTube, Facebook, Periscope, Twitch, your cell phone, satellite, network, UPN, wherever you're watching us, make sure that you go to Twitter. To enter our contest to win. So we've got, what's ironic about that is that's Baker Mayfield and Sam Darnold. Mm-hmm. And I have Josh Allen, Kerryon Johnson, Saquon Barkley. So we're actually not having overlap. We're giving them a chance at almost all of the big names. And thanks again to Panini for letting us have access to that event.
Yes.
And letting us also share it with so many wonderful shops. I think honestly, at the end of the day, as much fun as it is to hang out with the players for 3 minutes, the best part is interviewing those shop owners, interviewing those breakers, getting to know them a little bit. Everybody from, you know, Brian, who's there every year, and the guys at Mojo Break and Jaspy's who are there every year, to Alexander at Valley Sports Cards, not far from us, a little far in LA terms, but who they've gotten invited every year, but they've given it to some of their top customers as an incentive. And so this year he brought his guys from the shop for the first time, or the Break Room Texas, the Break Room from Texas, coming out his very first, rookie premiere, and just his eyes were so wide, and he's such a good guy, provides so much support on social media, that it was really cool to be able to see them be able to partake in that event. So that said, you guys know how to enter, you guys know how to win. Thank you, guys and gals, for watching us tonight, despite the technical difficulties, and hanging in with us. Hey, we've got more segments for you, though. We're not going anywhere. In fact, it's a new week in the shop.
That's right.
Which means we have what's hot in the shop.
That's
for our viewers now.
That's right, Ivan. And hitting stores next Wednesday, May 30th, is a basketball product, a new basketball product from Panini. 2017-18 Panini Essentials NBA basketball cards. It's a new product. That features cards printed on stunning holographic cardstock and is loaded with colorful inserts and parallels. And you're going to find two autograph cards in every box. The set's got rookie autographs. So you're going to get, I mean, it's all the top NBA rookies. And what better time to pull a Donovan Mitchell or a Lonzo Ball?
No better time.
Or a... John Collins, or a, I'm going to go deep, or Maxi Kleber, this week's Future Watch rookie player
He's
profile that I wrote today. He might be the next Dirk. That's a very high projection. But anyway, he could be. Claim to fame signatures. Panini Essentials Basketball has claim to fame signatures where you can relive championship moments in this stellar autograph insert of players who raised the Larry O'Brien trophy. So you're going to see Lakers, Spurs, all the greatest players from those teams. True potential signatures. Collect autographs featuring the fantastic first-year talents of the NBA. So it's going to be a rookie parallel set, which will obviously be great, featuring all of them. All I already named them: Donovan Mitchell, Dennis Smith Jr., and then That's It for Greatness is the other autograph set. There's going to be a lot of insert sets. License to Dominate, which is a rare insert set with die cut corners, and facsimile. Ooh. Autograph.
I like that.
Yeah. Kobe's all-rookie team. Kobe is back, and he's going to pick the all-rookie team. I wonder if Lonzo Ball is on it. He probably is. Sure. Franchise Foundations, Kings of the Court, Indispensable Stars, Rock the Rim, Swish Kings, Worldwide Wonders, and there might even be more. There's going to be a lot of parallels in the set. Gold, silver, platinum. Purple is the one-of-one color on this year's set. So, basketball's hot. It's super hot, and people are going to be going after these hot rookies. And the Kobe all rookie team looks great, and it's got Kobe and a rookie. Definitely check this set out when it hits stores next Wednesday, May 30th.
Thank you, James. Also hitting shops on Wednesday, going to the Diamond for Topps Pro Debut baseball cards. Each box is going to deliver two autographed cards, two memorabilia cards, and even more exciting, one team logo sticker box topper in every box. So keep a sharp eye out for those team logo sticker box toppers, because that's part of what is great about this product. It's fun while also giving you, we should talk about the case hit. It gives you a splash of the future, including the case hit splash of the future autographed cards. Incredible checklist this year. Lots of top prospects that people are looking forward to, hoping get called up, including Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
There he is.
Not quite the Hall of Famer yet. It's Vladimir Guerrero's son, who has been lighting it up, hitting over 400 and tons of home runs in AAA right now, or AA, I think. Wherever it is, he's lighting it up, along with names like Fernando Tatis Jr., Royce Lewis, lots of great names, and Gleyber Torres, Kevin Maton, some of the guys that we've already seen some love from. Some of the memorabilia cards actually look beautiful. Including Fragments of the Far, which is a mainstay of Pro Debut, returns featuring unique pieces of MILB memorabilia, minor league baseball, and the new Distinguished Medallion cards commemorating the most prolific debuts of the game's stars with a manufactured medallion piece. And, like I said, fun product in addition to the autographs and the prospecting, Promo Night uniform relicks showcasing jumbo swatches of some of the most popular game-used jerseys originating from the well-known promotional nights across minor league baseball. All relic sets will also feature low-numbered parallels. And, of course, plenty of inserts, a 200-card base set to chase, low-numbered parallels, and rare, randomly inserted autograph parallels. So, not a huge hit product, but there are low-numbered autograph parallels, in addition to the two autographs you will get in every box. Look for Topps Pro Debut on store shelves this week.
And the checklist for that set just dropped today. So if you know...
And is it updated on GoGTS?
Sure is. I posted it.
All
right. Coming up next is... and it is hitting stores on, actually, this Friday. It's actually hitting stores tomorrow. Hot in the shop now. It's going to be hot in the shop on Monday when this video is embedded in a blog post that is also previewing the releases. And I wonder if it'll be included in the post. But anyway, 2018 Leaf Greatest Hits Football. It delivers four buyback cards and one Valiant Greatest Hits Football rookie card in every box. Only 300 cases of this product was produced for 2018. So it's going to be some good stuff in here. You're going to get every box delivers four buyback cards, one Valiant Hits rookie football card. For the buybacks, you're going to find graded vintage cards, graded rookie cards, autograph cards, rare memorabilia cards, and modern star and rookie cards. And then the Valiant Hits, we know that design. It's a sharp design featuring rookie footballers. I'm looking at the sell sheet now, and I see...
Also, if I can interrupt real quick, James, we did feature this last week. As we know, sometimes these releases get pushed a week. But I tweeted at Leaf on Twitter, and I did ask, there are colored parallel versions of those Greatest Hits football rookie cards. However, there are not autographs.
Okay, so they're just going to be base.
But so there
cards
are
with parallel
there's base
versions
cards, but there's also parallels.
I see.
With numbers. So you can look for that in this product. Leaf did confirm, and we appreciate their communication on that.
And if you see the video now, you're going to see some. You know, there's some big cards in there. There's Aaron Rodgers rookies, Jimmy Garoppolo rookies, Tom Brady, Dan Marino. I mean, it's what you come to expect from a Leaf buyback football product, and it's their greatest hits. So this is big for them, and you can find it in stores tomorrow. So if anybody's ripping it or breaking it, let's see what you're getting out of this set.
James, I can't wait to talk about this next set because you know I'm not a huge racing fan, but I love unique cards. And the people I know behind this product have been most hyped for this year when it comes to racing cards. 2018 Panini Victory Lane Racing Cards. This product is going to have four packs per box with 10 cards in each. So it's not the craziest product. It's not a one pack, one hit product. But each box is going to deliver two autographed cards, two memorabilia cards, four game parallels, four inserts, and four pedal to the metal holographic inserts in every box to give you just a little idea of why I'm excited for it. And Panini's saying you will find a top six driver autographed card in every case. So for those of you that know the checklists of or know the rankings of drivers, you know what that means. For me, I got to go to the checklist, but guess where I find the checklist? GoGTS.net, along with all this other great product information, videos, and blogs. So this particular product is loaded with high tech. There's going to be three different substrates: holographic, metalized with etch, and C2S. I don't even know what that stands for, and I'm excited. You can look for 2018 rookies like William Byron, Bubba Wallace, Christopher Bell, and more. Again, two autographed cards in every box, including Octane autographs, a 40-card insert set with on-card autographs from some of the greatest drivers on the circuit today. Victory marks showcasing 20 of the best drivers to ever get behind the wheel with, again, on-card autographs from the legends of NASCAR. And then Remarkable Remnants featuring a piece of race-used material and an on-card autograph. And if we see half the attention to detail in this that we saw from last week's break of Panini NASCAR National Treasures Racing, those Remarkable Remnants will truly be remarkable. Also, the additional memorabilia cards you can find include Engineered to Perfection, a triple materials card featuring drivers with three swatches of race-used material, Victory Lane Patches nameplate cut right from the driver's fire suit, NASCAR at 70, honoring NASCAR turning 70 this year. This insert set is going to feature 10 of the most prominent drivers to ever take the track, and many more, as well as a base set to collect and parallels of that base set to collect. I mean, I've said enough. You've seen the images. This stands out to me like no other racing product that we've seen yet. Look for Panini Victory Lane in shops this week.
I think it's safe to say that Panini does racing right. Right?
Fair
I think
enough.
So.
Left.
Have you done oh, yeah, that's right. Left. It's all left turns. Very clever of you. Next week, May 30th, it's going to be the solo memorabilia release of the week, but it's a good one. 2018 TriStar Hidden Treasures Autographed Football Mini Helmets. So these are going to be little mini helmets, and you get one mini helmet in every box. All signatures are authenticated by TriStar, PSA, DNA, or JSA. Look for, and this is where you're going to find 2018 football draft picks. And they're also going to have the TriStar Touchdown Treasure Tickets thing going, which I believe was going last year, which gives you a chance, redeemable for full-sized autograph memorabilia, including signed footballs, helmets, photographs, jerseys, and more. Each case of TriStar Hidden Treasures autograph football mini helmets, it's going to contain six Hall of Famers, three football favorites, and one current star. And so the big thing is 2018 rookies. So you're going to get Sam Darnold on a USC helmet, Saquon Barkley on a Penn State helmet, Brian Bosworth on an Oklahoma helmet, and more. Autographed mini helmets, you can find names like Tom Brady, Alvin Kamara, Saquon Barkley, Sam Darnold, Odell Beckham Jr., Deshaun Watson, Barry Sanders, and many more. And then, of course, and I'll repeat it again, the TriStar Touchdown Treasure Tickets are in this year's set. And if you find one, they're redeemable for full-sized autographed memorabilia. So you could get a signed football, a full-size helmet, I think is how I'm reading that correctly, photographs, jerseys, and more. So it looks like a full-size helmet. So, this is... and Tom Brady might be one of those redeemable helmets.
Yeah, that's because, again, the way the pack out is, it's kind of obvious if it's a full-size helmet, so they do a redemption so that you can't really search for them.
Yeah.
But this is one product where you don't mind getting a redemption.
Right? No, because it's probably already in hand, too.
Exactly.
So, yeah, that's gonna hit stores next Wednesday, May 30th. And that is a look at what's hot in the shop.
Fire.
Indeed.
I want to rewind real quick. Like I said, I have a little bandwidth for comments, so I've been trying to track as many as I can. And Panda B just shared something really fun in response to the Panini Victory Lane. Apparently, when Panda won the Joey Logano National Treasures memorabilia card on here, a one of one that we hit, Panda sent it off to Joey, and he signed it through the mail.
Oh, nice.
So it's pretty cool. So make sure you tweet us and tag us in that so that we can
please
tweet it and share, because we'd love to see that. How cool is that? Is just a little fan story, though, real quick.
Indeed. And a one-on-one.
Yeah.
I mean, make it even more unique. I like it.
I love it. Well, we have another fun, unique piece of content for you, especially if you're a wrestling fan. And even if you're a casual wrestling fan, this is a well-known Impact wrestler, Velvet Sky, sat down or stood up, but met with our Russ Cohen. And I love the people that really go all out to do the independent wrestling circuit. You got to respect them. And she's a consummate professional. So watch now our Velvet Sky interview cardboard career retrospective with Russ Cohen.
And now I'm personal training.
Oh, you're personal training?
I do personal training. I always tell people I spent 16 years destroying my body in the ring for the love of my pro wrestling dream. And now I have to spend the rest of my life piecing myself back together, getting healthy one day at a time. So that's pretty much what I'm up to. I'm in the gym a lot.
Does it take a while, though, to get rid of all the bumps and bruises and everything?
Some of them never go away. I have just permanent neck pain, neck spasms every day, no matter which way I sit or turn my head up, down, lay down. It's just always, my neck's always going to be giving me problems. But if that's the least thing I walked away with injury-wise, then I'm happy. I knew it was time. You just have to know as a professional wrestler when your time is to kind of hang up.
You didn't have to get neck fusion surgery.
Thank God, no. I mean, there's people my age in this business, girls, a couple of girls that come to mind that had neck fusion surgery, and they had that not from one particular bump, but that's years and years of wear and tear. And I see stuff like that every day. It seems like every day I see one of my friends in wrestling, these horrible diagnoses with surgeries or cracked vertebrae or slipped discs or broken this, broken that. And I said, you know what? I had a satisfying career. I did all I set out to do in TNA. I had a great platform. I traveled the world, and now it's time to move on to the next chapter of my life, but I love the fans so much that I always make time to do signings, conventions like today.
Do you intentionally stay away from the WWE because you like TNA so much, because of the way they treated you and just the way they were different?
Well, TNA was my home for 10 years. TNA gave me the opportunity that I was looking for when I was trying to get signed to TV wrestling. They gave me the best opportunity, they gave me the ball, and I ran with it. And I'm always going to be very grateful to TNA. They will always be my home. As far as WWE, I just don't think their style fits my style. And I don't care about the money. People are like, oh, who cares about, you know, who cares what they want you to do? Just go there and make a lot of money. It's not all about money to me. I had a very successful career in TNA. I made a lot of money in TNA, and I'm not going to sell myself short just for money. Money right. is not the end all of my life. It's not the most important thing in my life. So I spend a lot of time in TNA working on creating the character of Velvet Sky, and to just give it all away to WWE pretty much would have worked my whole career for nothing. So WWE is definitely not in the cards for Velvet Sky, and I am 1,000% okay with that.
No, it makes sense. It really does. I mean, that's actually a really good message too, because you're right, they would probably trademark you and they would, you know.
Well, I wouldn't be able to be Velvet Sky, be whatever they wanted me to be. I would have to probably act how they wanted me to act, and it's fine. I'm not saying it's my way or the highway. It's just in TNA we had so much creative freedom to be able to
so you could be in charge of you,
right? Pretty, and that's what I do now. I do personal training, but I still do shows and signings. I just don't get in the ring. I make my own schedule. I travel the world. I meet awesome fans, and it's on my own schedule. It's not, I don't have anybody breathing down my neck or telling me where to go and how to look and how to act. It's not for me.
How did you break it to your parents that you were dropping out of school and becoming a wrestler? In my house, that wouldn't have gone over.
Well, the thing is, my parents, thankfully, are super cool and super supportive, and they pretty much knew how much I loved wrestling, and they weren't happy about it at first, trust me. I lived on campus, and I would come home on the weekends, so every weekend, my father, for 2 years, was driving up back and forth, to get me and bring me home. So after a year and a half of that, when I told them no more, I mean, they weren't ecstatic. They were disappointed, slightly disappointed, but when they learned what I was doing, my reasons, and they saw me working so hard to pursue my dream of being a wrestler, they supported me 100%, and I'm blessed to have them.
Who was the one wrestler that drew you in? Like, who was the one that you watched, male or female, that you said, you know what, I'm going to be the next?
I loved Lita. I was a huge fan of wrestling during the Attitude Era. In my opinion, the Attitude Era of WWF was the best era of wrestling ever. And it's my opinion. There were just so many, like there were just so many awesome characters and storylines. And I mean, you had Stone Cold, The Undertaker, The Dudley Boys, Mankind, you know? I mean, those were all larger-than-life characters that kind of drew me in week after week. It was like, oh my God, I can't miss an episode of Raw. The Monday Night Wars, WCW, WWF, ECW. That was like the highlight of the wrestling world, in my opinion. And it's just not the same. It doesn't have the same feel now. But when I was watching it, before I got into wrestling, I remember watching Lita, and I was there the night she made her debut with S.A. Rios. At that point, I had already started seeking out wrestling schools. I hadn't found one yet, but when I saw Lita performing, I was like, oh my God, she's so cool.
She's
pretty. She's hot. I'm like, she appeals to the guys, the girls. Everyone loves her. She was so athletic and so flashy in the ring. I'm like, one of these days, I'm going to do that. It took a while. It took a long, bumpy road of independence to finally get noticed by TNA, but I'm so blessed and lucky to have had the career that I had, especially since I've accomplished everything I set out to do in wrestling, and I don't need anything else other than what I've already been blessed with.
James, you can probably guess how I felt about that interview. A wrestler who's working the entire circuit, not just what's most popular, has a great wrestling name, so many great cards, articulate. If there was more like that, I would be a bigger wrestling fan. I would carve out time to be a bigger wrestling fan. As many of the viewers pointed out, intelligent, well-spoken, And also really fun how many cards there were, right?
A ton. Did you expect that, James? Wow. They've been making sets throughout the years, and she's been in a lot of different ones. So good for her.
Yeah. So thank you to Russ Cohen at Sportsology on social media or sportsology.net for some more of his original content. And thank you to him as well for all of the content he provides for GoGTS.net. Oh, I didn't realize that it's cropped out of the video. It just says GoGTS.
He's a star, that Russ. Move that over. He's got a lot of good stuff for us. So,
Will James, I have some bad news. It seems that Rob Bertrand, he's been working diligently for the last 2 hours and 45 minutes, really, because we started before the show was supposed to start, started working on this. Not going to be able to get the box break camera up. So
sad.
You're going to have to do two things. You're going to have to pay attention to social media and YouTube throughout the week. If you're not subscribed to them already, make sure you do. Look out for the May prize pack, because if one of the ways to enter to win is to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you get notifications when videos come up, because there may be some box break recap where we do the giveaways, and then we may also hold, especially the Panini Majestic, hold that. So the second thing is next week, be sure to tune in, right?
You got to tune in. Next week, no, we got these boxes to break. We have this $300 box of Panini Majestic NFL football cards. We have this box of
2017-18
Panini Dominion NBA basketball cards, where we could pull possibly a Jason Tatum auto. He's still playing in the playoffs, guys.
Yeah.
Why would you bring up John Collins or Dennis Smith Jr. or De'Aaron Fox when Jason Tatum is still in the playoffs? We also have a box of classics. Rob's got three of them, all from Panini. He's going to open them next week. Don't worry, guys.
Awesome. That said, we do have some extra bonus giveaways in addition to the four. So remember, this is a pack of four. So the lowest hits are going to be packed together for one collector, and then three other on-card autographs. And the two 8x10s, Baker Mayfield, the number one pick in the draft, and Sam Darnold. Every single time I see his name, I want to add an apostrophe there and make it French and say Darnold. But no, it is Darnold of the New York Jets. So, James, without further ado, I picked some winners during that last video from the tweet draw, and I've got some names. Are you ready for this? Let's hear it.
Good luck, everybody.
You got since we don't have the soundtrack, do you have a little drum roll yourself? Are you a drummer? Are you a backseat drummer? I don't know what that means. Whether you are or not. Okay, so first off, the prize pack giveaway. So Saquon Barkley rookie image variation, Damon Webb auto, and Ronnie Harrison numbered to 25 is going to Scott the Chicken. So Scott, if you have wings, fly, and if you have fingers, shoot us an email to claim your prize. GoGTS Live, the name of the show, at GoGTS.net, the name of the website. So that's how you do an email address. You send it to a website. Yep. GoGTS Live at GoGTS.net. Send us your name, your mailing address, and what you want.
And you know what? If you don't get a response to the email, do not worry. Rob's got a lot. Rob's the one who does this. It's you know, he's got a lot of things on his plate, and he can't reply to each and every email saying, "Hey, I got your email. It went in the mail. Here's the tracking number." Trust us. If you send the email to GoGTSLive at GoGTS.net, you include what you won and your shipping information, you're golden. Don't worry.
It will show up. It will. That said, do follow us and engage with us on social media, because we love it.
We do.
And share the posts and spread some more stuff. And again, the May Stravaganza prize pack is huge, and you still have 1 week to enter to win. So look out for more tweets on that. Click the profile links. If they have been changed, we'll change them back. We'll make it easy for you on all of our social media channels, including Instagram.
You,
sorry, bro. I'm getting distracted. We got prizes to give away. But make sure you're following on Instagram, GTS Sports Entertainment. Lots of fun out there, plus stories. We do Instagram stories now. We had some behind-the-scenes content of the NFLPA Rookie Premiere that you didn't even see in the videos. It was only available for 24 hours in that story content. That said, let's move it along. Kerryon Johnson, hot rookie from Auburn, running back for the Detroit Lions. That card is going to go to Chad Reed. Congratulations, Chad, a regular viewer of the show. Email us, GoGTSLive at GoGTS.net.
Was that the guy who was playing Connect Four?
That was the guy that was playing Connect Four in the video that we saw.
Now,
so
he did lose in the video. The video told a little story about his game with the Panini gal, but he lost that game, but he won another. So
yeah, he won the overall challenge. Yeah. I think they did best out of five. Yeah. All right, speaking of awesome people from the rookie premiere, Josh Allen spent a lot of time. Even the parts of the video where he was interacting with collectors were at like 2:30 on day 3.5 for him in the blistering heat, and he was still totally cool, totally kind, and signed this for one of you. Who did he sign it for? He signed it for Jason Rocco. Congratulations, Jason. Email us. You know the drill. You've been watching for a long time. And then finally, from the cards, we have the Saquon Barkley, Mike Gesicki dual auto. Now, I got Saquon first, and I said, I don't know if this is cool or not, but I asked him specifically. I said, should I get Mike's on there or just leave it like it was? And he was like, no, man, Mike's going to be a star. You got to get him on there. Saquon's exact words. So this is an extra special card on card from both of these two amazing rookies. And that is going to Big E, B-I-G-G-E, at CardTrader20 on Twitter. So go ahead and email us, gogtslive@gogts.net. And I don't have anything to show you now, but imagine in your head an 8x10 of Baker Mayfield on the Panini Classics design. Big, giant, oversized thing shipped to you. Easy to imagine if your name is Alex Kent. Congratulations, Alex. Email us, gogtslive@gogts.net. And finally, the Sam Darnold 8x10 from Panini Classics from the NFLPA Rookie Premiere autographed goes to viewer Carl Ingram. All right. Ooh, the bubbles are getting to me. The probiotic is kicking in. I guess that means that the show is almost done, except there is a tease.
Well, hold on. So you know, I have this great guest guide that was given away, and you gave this to me because I wanted to spell names correctly for when I made these videos.
Yeah.
Sam Darnold, here's the fun fact. He enjoys going to the beach, body surfing, and building his own sushi rolls. How about that?
That's a cool, fun fact. We should actually keep that in if when we pull these autographs of any of these guys during the year, you got to have those fun facts.
Yeah, I will.
Ready for
you
us.
Know
all
what?
Right,
that's
James?
Nice.
Part of being the asset that you are. Well,
DJ
thank you, James,
Chark,
for stepping up today.
Wide receiver for the Jacksonville Jaguars. Fun fact, growing up, he never missed a day of school.
Wow.
Yeah, okay. But yeah.
That's why he's in the NFL and I'm not. Yeah,
right.
So real quick, programming note for next week, in addition to all of the fun carryovers, we're also going to have guest Kevin Keating, who, as we mentioned earlier, is the author of the aforementioned book, Waiting for a Sign, about his decades-long chase of professional athletes and celebrities' autographs, along with a signed book giveaway. So you're going to get Kevin's signature in there, and then your job is to go and get every athlete that he mentions in the book to sign on that page of the book.
Ugh. Sounds like
for
work.
my co-host tonight. Yeah, well, some people will. Yeah. Kevin's protege will do it. So that's our show tonight. Yeah. Thank you everyone for watching. Thank you, James, for the incredible work behind the scenes making those videos happen, and then for stepping in for my general co-host Rob Bertrand, the voice of the collector. You can follow James on Twitter @gojpg. Watch him for sly, witty ones. He's always watching.
I am. Watching, but not always commenting. But if there's something to say,
you're a sniper.
Yeah.
You're a Twitter sniper.
Sure.
It's good. We need those in a world where I'm allowed on Twitter.
That's right.
And I am on Twitter @WatchTheBreaks. But make sure you follow the show and GTS Distribution on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, everywhere for your hobby news. And remember, always be collecting.
See ya.